First, we will see the how to delete the foreign key. So our objective is to delete the foreign key, okay, in a table. So that is our question. So now, first we will see. Now, as we know, before performing any operation on the data space, we have to use the database. And database is nothing which is a collection of the interdated file. So we are working on the interdated file that is known as the tables. So first I will use the database, that is the our database name is 20pi. So I'm choosing this one. Now I'm executing this code. Now you will be able to see at the bottom side, this code is perfectly executed over here. It means now we are now entered to the our database. So from this left side panel, you can see we have a table, views, stored procedure and function. Is it visible to our right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now we have a foreign key. So you can see here. Now you can see in the foreign key, we don't have any foreign key. Is it clear to write? It is visible to all right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is our command by which we can see? That is a simple thing. So first we have used the database. So use the database we have done. Now we have used this point right now. After this point, let us create some tables. So let us create two tables. Okay. So first table I'm create a table. Table name. What is the table name? I'm giving table name just like parent. Okay, for understanding purpose. Parent. Because parent table will provide the reference to the child table. So I'm giving the parent or child table name. Just randomly I'm taking. So create a table name, I'm just giving its value for its ID. So I can write this is a PID, and it would be integer. And I'm passing the size randomly 2 only, no issue. And comma. Now I'm just using another part right now, just randomly I'm taking only here. And another part, whatever you want to take, just like the name. So you can take the different name, so no issue, whatever you want to do. Okay, so I'm just defining size just 25 and defining. Now I'm creating this file without the primary key. So if I need to add primary key, so how to add the primary key? It's very simple syntax. So what is the syntax? Our syntax will be simple. For the clear encryption, I'm just writing the thing here. So first we have to use a primary key. So primary key, so which key must be primary key as according to our table, ID must be primary key. So this would be the syntax. Now we are not having any issues. Now we are not having any error. So because we are not getting the right cross symbol. Now this is clear to all right now.
So it would be PID.
Yeah, definitely. So I just need to know you are still awake or sleeping. So thanks for giving this idea. Now PID will be here. So now we got our correct syntax right now along with this thing properly. So let me execute this code in front of you. And now you can see at the bottom side, this table is perfectly created. So what is the description of this table? So let me show the description of this table. Description of the table, that is the parent, I can write over here. You can see the description of this table, that is the PID is become the primary key. So you can see over here. It is clear to all right now. So far, it is clear to all right now.
Yes, sir.
Now, let me create one more table that will keep the reference of the PID into the its child table. So I'm creating another table, that is a table, create table. Table name is child. Okay, child. Child. And I'm giving its CID, that is a child. Okay, so yeah. CID is the child ID. So I'm giving its ID, whatever size you can pass, you can use. And I'm just creating another variable, whatever you want to use, then I can say, just like I'm taking the P1 ID. Okay. So to avoid the confusion, just I'm taking this name as a P1 ID. So P1 ID, I'm taking integer size. I can take the size to suppose whatever you want to put, you can take, no issue. Another parameter, if you want to take just like the name, CNAME is child name. So I can take this name like this one. So whatever size you want to pass, you can pass. And that's enough. So from this point, you can easily check if I want to make the primary key and if I want to make the foreign key, so I can make. So CID would be the primary key, so I can write which will be the primary key. So primary key, that is I can make the CID. Okay, primary key would be the CID. Okay, now it is clear to so far? Is it clear so far? Now I am making the child ID as a primary key, so I am making it clear. Now, is it clear to all right now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now I am defining the foreign key. It's very simple way. Foreign key. Foreign key. Which should be the foreign key? The foreign key should be the P1 ID. P1 ID, good. And that will keep the references from the our parent table. So this would be the parent and the which one? That is a PID. This syntax is clear. In the previous class we have seen this is clear to right now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I'm executing this code in front of you. So now it will be executed perfectly. So you can easily check over here. Let me show the description of this table. So I'm just executing this code in front of you. So you can easily check now CID becomes a primary key and while P1 ID becomes a foreign key. So it will keep the or it is allowed to have the duplicate record. So it is also having the multiple key, which is also known as. So this is the structure, this is the physical level, the physical by using the physical schema we have prepared. So now it's time to use the logical level by which we can enter some data. So what we have to do now, let us insert some data into these tables. As we know what we are doing, so first I'm just trying to insert some data, insert into what is the table name, that is the parent, so I can put over here. So in the parent table, as we know, what is the different values I can put. So what are the values? PID, age, name, and these three attributes we have to use. So PID, I'm taking the 1, 2, 3 randomly, and age, I'm taking 56, something just randomly, and name, I'm taking the myself neighbor here. So this is the first record I'm inserting. So let me execute this code. Yes, this code is already inserted over here now after executing this code. So this one record I can insert, but if I need to insert the multiple records at the same time, so I can do just like this one. So just use the comma symbol and put all these records. So randomly I can put some data just like this, 785, age 26, and the name I am just changing. Okay. Now next I am just inserting the more ID, just like 64, comma age is 13, and name could be anything, just like I'm just putting my surname only. Okay, and then put the next data. So randomly I can take the 65, 56 I can take, and 90 age I can take, and next name I can take randomly OP to something like this one. So after inserting these three data, you can easily check, we can do. So now these three data is sufficient to insert, so without any problem. So we have the, we are getting any error over, not over here. So let me check where we are getting the error. Insert into parent values, we are using this one, comma. Necessary, we have just should be removed. Now, after executing this code, we have inserted the three records. So let me execute the syntax by which we can say select star from the parent, so you can easily check from parent. Now, you have seen, now I have inserted some data. It is clear to all right now, it is visible to all right now.
Yes, sir.
Now let me refresh this part over here. So you can see in our child table or child relation, we have created the foreign key and it has its constraint, that is CIILDIBFK_1. So this is its difference. So if you want to remove the foreign key, then we can remove the its constraint, then it will allow to have the duplicate record, or it will allow to have the non-reference values. Just let me show the my proof. So if I'm trying to insert some data into the my parent child table, so insert into the child. So what is the values I can put? So what are the values I can insert? So as we know, in the parent we have the CID, PID, CNAME, only these three things we have. The CID I can take any randomly, just I'm taking the very sequentially, I can take 1, 2. Then here I can take the any random value 90 I'm taking, and I'm taking the name only, just random name I'm taking over here. If I try to insert this value, so what will be happen? 90 is not a part of the our 90 is not a part of the our parent ID. So what are the parent ID we have? We have the parent ID. I'm just writing the parent ID over here. What are the parent ID we have inserted? 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 5. You can see from the my screen 64 and 56. These are the four parent ID I have. So then these four parent ID I'm taking as a reference over here. If I try to insert some different ID, that is 90, so that is not our ID. So error must be put it over here. So let me do this code over here. So you can see the 20 BI child does not exist, because the particular references we are looking for, that is not matching to our domain. That should be the 1, 2, 3, 7, 8, 5, 64, 56. So if I'm doing some amendment over here in front of you, it's suppose that I'm putting here randomly 64 I'm taking, and now let me execute this code in front of you. So now you can see again we are getting this point. What is the problem we are getting? Just let me check over here. CID, we have the P1 ID and the CNAME, we have no issue.
Spelling of child.
Oh yeah, good, thank you. Yeah, so this first let me again use the 90 to rectify your concept. So cannot add or update the child row because foreign key constraint failed. Now it is clear to right now, because 90 is not a part of the our domain that belong to the parent relation. Now it is clear to all right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Instead of, so I can write over here the above code will not be executed due to not having a reference, from parent table. If I'm executing this code by the different and appropriate thing, so if I'm using the 64 rather than the 90, so let me use this syntax and what we can say. This will be added over here because 64 is a part of the our parents. Okay, so I can write over here, this record will be added because 64 is a domain value of parent. It is clear to right now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we can try to insert many row over here. So that is the point. So what if I am dropping the foreign key? So if I'm dropping the foreign key, so the syntax, we have a very simple syntax by which we can drop. But what has happened over here? We can drop the constraint. So how to see the what is the constraint we have the our foreign key? So from this our panel, you can easily check. I'm referencing once again from the our this child table. From the left panel, you can see the child table which contains the number of the column indexes foreign key. So it has the foreign key that is identified by the its constraint, that is child underscore IVF key underscore 1. Is it visible? It is clear to all right now?
Yes, sir.
And it is targeting, you see, everything is written here. In the definition part, you can see it is targeting the parent ID and PID. Okay. That's why we have this point. So parent P1 ID, we are taking as a reference from the P1 ID. So first, what we have to do, we have to remove the constraint so we can easily do the thing properly. So let me just try to explore one more idea over here. Suppose I just need to insert in the child table values. I'm trying to insert 90 comma. Okay, I'm just checking randomly. 34 comma. I'm just choosing the 55 comma. This student name or just child information I need to insert. So 55 is not a part of the domain value. So if I try to execute, so let me execute. So what is the message you are getting? You can see over here. So I cannot add or update a child row because of foreign key constraint failed. So this is should be clear right now. So let me rectify all these things. So how we can resolve this issue? So I can say we can drop or remove the foreign key by removing its foreign key constraint. So what is the syntax why we can do this activity? So that is a simple command that defines the our constraint. So what is the thing we can do? So let me use the proper thing. So what we have to use, we have to use first we have to remove the constraint of the foreign key. So if I'm removing the constraint, then the reference will be removed automatically. So you can easily check. So alter table, and I'm just trying to what I'm doing right now, we are removing FK. I'm writing short, okay, FK constraint. Okay, and but before that, let me show the syntax. What is the syntax? Why we can see the constraint? So the simple syntax, simple command we have that is known as a show create table, and what is the name of the table? Child. By which we can see. So you can see easily over here. Are you able to see the its create table? So in this point, you can see the constraint. Are you able to see this constraint part? That is the child underscore IVFK underscore one. Child underscore IVFK underscore one. So this is a foreign key constraint. If we remove this one, then our constraint will be passed. So while I try to update the our values that does not match with our domain, so it will be also possible. Just do one thing. You can remove this constraint. So foreign key concept will be failed. Now it is visible to all. Child underscore IBFK underscore one.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what I'm doing right now, I'm just trying to do. Okay. So the below query is used to see the FK constraint. Okay. Now we create. Now we are trying to remove the constraint. So what is the syntax? So I can use this thing properly. So now we are altering table name. What is the table name from which we have to remove the constraint? That is our child. So alter table child and drop foreign key constraint. So foreign key we have to use foreign key. And what is the name of the constraint? As I told you, child child underscore IVFK underscore one. So we can remove the constraints, our foreign key will be removed. So for the concept of the foreign key will be removed. So alter table child drop foreign key child underscore IBFK underscore. Now should I execute this code? No. Now tell me right now, everything is clear so far?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. First I'm executing this code and let me check. at the bottom side, you can see this code is run perfectly without any doubt. So now I have removed the constraint. Let us see the its constraint is visible or not. So you can see. So now you can see after the key, now constraint was no more available over here. Now, are you able to see? No, because constraint is removed. As you can see, at the left panel side is also coming over. Just first, let me refresh and show me the my proof. After removing this point, so now there is no more constraint are available inside the foreign key part of the child table. Is it available? No or yes? Tell me right now.
No, sir.
Okay, that's why we have removed the constraint on the foreign key. So now the key we have been applied on the child, it is also possible to have the data that is not a part of the domain. So we can also insert such part. Can I show the my proof over here? It is also possible. Now, if you try to insert this record, this was a fail to do so. Yes. So let us try to add a new record in which we are not referencing any data or value from parent table. Okay, this was our syntax. So now we are trying to insert this one. So 55 is not a part of the our parent ID, but if we try to do so, if it is not a part, then we must have an error. So if you have to remove the constant, it should be added. If it is adding the error, if it is adding the data into our table, it means now we have removed the constant. So now we have removed the foreign key features. Let me execute this code in front of you. So now, yeah, it is now executed. It is executed perfectly. You can see, is it executed? Just tell me right yes, now, it is executed. Okay. So if I'm executing two syntax, just keep in mind right now, select star from the parent. So now what are the PID 56, 64, 124, 785? I'm repeating once again, you have just keep in mind 56, 64, 123, 785. Okay. After this point, I'm executing one more key as command, select star from the child. Now you can see 12 and in the PID we are adding the 64. 64 was the previously, we can say, of course we have added, so that was a part of that. But 55 is not a part of the our domain value of the or domain or set of the domain of the our parent ID. But now it is added because we have removed this feature. So now we are not taking the dot references is not more. So what we have now, we have no more referencing from parent table. That's why what we have removed foreign key concept from the table. Now it is clear to all right now. This is the our removing the foreign key concept. It is clear to all right now.
Yes, sir.
So this was a very simple command by which we have seen to how to remove the foreign key.